Right, so last lap for today. Debus. Okay, so where were we? Probably you this month. Where is you this month? So many. So the first one require ABC. Send message. Really long day. Dated up. Dated up, man. Do this one already. D said D. Do this, yep, also. This shell. Also. TVSD. Also. Now search provider and this. I guess we need to do those. TMI session, did you do that already? I am set check. I am set check. This is one way and this is two ways. Set D. I am set D. This one. Deconf, there we go. I am set D for deconf. Yeah, we did. For DVSD. No, we didn't do. Oh, but I'm looking at the wrong. One. I am set D. Yep, we did. I am check, we did. And I am sets, we probably didn't. Oops. Damn. So it's basically only this one. Now to the search provider, well, we probably have most of these nodes. So at sp p, yep, we do have that. This one we'll need to keep. And I'm pretty sure the remainder we also have. What all this? Almost there. Network manager applet. Oh, this is the wrong one though. This is in the wrong section. Damn. Messy. Damn, this is messy. This is messy. First of all, this is in the wrong section, and second of all, it's just a mess. Let's just put this in the right place. Abort. Okay. ABIT Apple. Pulse audio. Pulse. I'll just go look for it myself. TPMC. Service provider, keyring, shell, and have most of these. TR minor FS. TR minor FS. I guess these are all done except these. And then the TR store, and then we're at least done in this run. Let's see if this builds. Built. Actually, we should probably remove all those permissive domains, because we've been running in permissive mode anyway, so we hadn't actually needed for big projects like this. Permissive domains aren't all that useful. So it's installed. Log off. Se 1726. Jesus Christ. Give me a break, please. 1736. Grab XDM, grab execute, quick question. Okay, let's get back to the dams. Last step. There's stuff that needs to be done. There's stuff that needs to be done first. A lot, all of a sudden. Abort applet. ABRT apple. And this was about config home t. There, get attribute. One issue. Deconf XP. Der Gratitude. Evolve source as a C-Rag. Play. Evo SR C-Rag. So we have cash home to get attribute. Evolution cash home to get attribute. And then we have data home to get attribute. Actually a read of a file. It's getting too late. I'm losing my focus. Decon search provider. Contact cash home. Dus contact cash home. Dus contact cash home. Dus it's a good attribute, isn't it? Decon for key ring diamond. Get ID. And of course that's not to be found. KID, and this is for deconf. Confirmity. Video ID. This is DOA, the config home, the get attribute. This session, well, first this session config home T. There's session config home. Get attribute. And we also have a ice out home t file read. Ice out home t file read. And I saw some ice out read. Then we have a lot of bullshit, shell exec, XDM, setting daemon once to search in environment T. T set D. Actually. We have shell doing some stuff again. Bin keeps doing that. I have known. Give me a fucking break, please. We have set the two. Now I see. Set the data home to dir and I was get attribute. Now we have this login user which gets bigger and bigger. TPMC. Space isn't working, and this TPMC is data home to their file. Then we have tr minor fs, unlinking a file in tr cache. TR minor fs and then TR store cache and then it's unlinking a file. TR store cache and data. So we have TR store cache, home to get attribute of a dir. And we have data home to read file. Then we have a bunch of stuff here, xdg, I'll probably related to this stuff here. So we have dtk home file, oh that's actually, and user home to their get attributes. Okay. A lot of work. I'm glad so it's about dinner time, so I'm going to boot once more, fix one round of bugs, and then peruse the policy a little bit in permissive mode, and then I'm going to quit because I had it. For today, I've had it for today. guy. Five, seven. No matches. That's something you don't see every day. It's getting slow and slow and slow, of course. Cash home search. Search for Canberra. Cash home search. Executing a shell, but that's, I don't audit it. This is actually required for I'll just make a note of that. Locale link file, this one should go up. Anyways. Here is that locale. And I'll just also add the hardware data there. Yeah. A little bit messy this. SysFS stuff. I'll just allow that. SysFS, where is that? But it's still needed. It ain't one thing, it's another. And security T. Dir get attribute, file system get attribute. Try to get that done. See if this builds. No, it doesn't. Syntax error allow. All right. Security FS. Security. As a transfer and T. As a transfer and T. XDM XDT. XDM ETC, XDM ETC, yeah, XDM home T, well, I'll be damned. finally. Ti immagino. Oh man. So, one last look at the situation right now. So we still have some ABC denials. We still have some ABC denials, but not that many are visible. But we aren't doing anything. We're just logging in, and that's it, and logging out. So let's have a look. PS aux, this is the same. Grab my login user. So we have all these processes confined. Let's grab 1012. So we have all these processes confined. And let's have a look at temp. Well, there's not much created there currently, but pulls audio, creates its content with the right type, and other than that, this user, my login user, doesn't create anything here currently. So let's have a look at LSLZ run user 1012. How does that look? So we have a confined there, we have a confined TVFS there, we have a confined keyring daemon there, but this KRB is basically created by TDM. I can see that because the identity system used, so it's probably by the TDM session worker or something like that. But if you look inside of there, then you'll see that the actual file that's in there is confined. So it's a primary temp. Yeah, I just used this type because I didn't know what type to use, but at least it's confined, it's protected. So, and then this symlink here is created by systemd logind probably or something. And so that's that. And then let's look, have a look at the home directory. LSL home my login user. So as you can see, everything is confined except the stuff that shouldn't be confined. So for example, these templates, videos, public pictures, music, downloads, documents, desktop, those there are generic user home content. So that's basically content that eventually every confined domain should just basically be able to fully manage. So we're not trying to protect generic content here. We're just trying to protect everything that's not generic content. So we could basically also protect bash stuff if we wanted to, although I'm not sure if that's useful, but it would be possible. So let's have a look at these cache content, config and local share directories. And as you can see, pulse audio is fully confined, out authority, the bookmarks are confined, protected. So let's have a look at LS cache first. Cache. Damn. Cache. So in the cache directory, everything is confined. You have abort protected. You have abort cache. There's, you have a sound event cache file, which is confined. You have the evolution cache home and contacts, and you have GDM, which is basically created by the session worker, GDM session worker. I can see that because it's system U. And then you'll have the IM settings daemon content and the tracker store content. It's all not restricted because you can't restrict the file, but it's all protected. So let's have a look at config. And as you can see, same for this stuff here, it's all protected. It's all created with a private type. So you have a protected base currently. Let's have a look at local share. Local. Now there's a single directory share which is protected, and inside the share directory we have subdirectories which are also all protected. So that means that basically we have a solid base right now, but we aren't doing anything yet. We're just logging in and logging out. We're not running any programs. We're not doing anything yet. So this is basically the goal is now to basically just be able to log in and log out confined. And if that is at some point working, then we have a base. Then I can truly say, okay, this is a solid base to work on. And then the nice things start, like confining stuff and confining user applications in a proper way. So that's basically, hopefully tomorrow we'll get to that point where I can say, okay, this is the base, this is where, this is our foundation, this is where we start doing the nice stuff. And it might even work now, but I won't even try, because there's always something that's popping up, some ABC denials that you haven't taken into account. You really need to test it thoroughly before you put it into enforcing mode. And even then, there probably is always somewhere an ABC denial hanging around that messes it up for you, for us. So with that said, that's basically it. We came a long way. We confined all processes. We protected all files except a few, like the bash stuff and the XDG simple directories. And that's basically part of a bigger plan. You'll see later why I decided to do that and why that is basically a good idea. So I'm going to log off now. I'm going to have dinner. It's been a long day, I guess. So 10 hours, I guess. I started at 8 o'clock and we're now at 6 o'clock in the evening. Actually a quarter past 6 o'clock in the evening. So it's like 10 hours SE Linux policy writing. So alright, I'm out.